Hello everyone, welcome to my channel SS Academy. In our last lesson on electricity, which was the first lesson in this series, we studied about some introduction and history of electricity, static electricity, current electricity, then voltages, currents, potential difference, EMF, resistors, fixed and variable, then Ohm's law and VI characteristics, voltmeter, ammeter, force on a charged particle, and then drift speed, symbols and functions of circuit components, etc. Now in today's lesson, we will study Kirchhoff's law. Now current and voltages in electrical circuits can be described with mathematical expressions and calculated by solving a set of equations. This is one of the reasons why advanced mathematics is so important in the field of electrical engineering. Ohm's law can determine the circuit equations and gives the relationship between voltage and current in a resistor. Kirchhoff's laws govern the currents entering or exiting a circuit node and the sum of voltages around a circuit loop respectively. Described by Kirchhoff in 1845, Kirchhoff's circuit laws are two equalities that deal with the conservation of charge and energy in electrical circuits. They are also called Kirchhoff's rules and are widely used in electrical engineering. Table of contents, Kirchhoff's laws, Kirchhoff's first law, which is also known as Kirchhoff current law, basic circuit definitions, Kirchhoff's second law, which is also known as Kirchhoff voltage law, circuit analysis with examples, voltage divider rule. Kirchhoff's laws. Kirchhoff's laws are fundamental to circuit theory. Quantitative analysis can be performed to flow of current through a circuit and voltage variation around a loop in a circuit. The currents at a node can be calculated using Kirchhoff's first law, known as current law. The voltage drop across components can be calculated using Kirchhoff's second law, also known as voltage law. Kirchhoff's first law. The sum of the currents leaving any junction is always equal to the sum of currents that entered it. In these diagrams, you can see that this is a node and currents flowing towards the node, they are labeled as A, B, C and D. And currents leaving this node are represented by letter E and F. So according to Kirchhoff's first law, A plus B plus C plus D must be equal to E plus F. Same here, I1 plus I2 plus I3, which are currents into the node. Entering the node equals currents leaving the node. So sum of all these currents must be equal to zero. Why these I4 and I5 are labeled as negative sign? Because they are leaving the node. Their direction is opposite to that of the initial currents I1, I2 and I3. So in sigma notation, in summation, we can write sigma I is equal to zero. Now, current flows when charge carriers move through conductors in a circuit. It is the rate at which this charge is carried through the circuit. Conservation of charge is a fundamental concept in physics. Therefore, current, the rate of flow of charge flowing into a node, must be the same as current flowing out of that node. Basic circuit definitions. We will come across different terminologies while studying Kirchhoff's rule, so it's important to define few basic circuit quantities. These are nodes, junctions, these are branches, and this is loop. Individually, I have drawn here. These are nodes, these are branches, which I have encircled. And starting from this node A, this is first loop, this is second loop, and this is third loop. Kirchhoff's second law. The total voltage across a circuit loop is equal to the sum of voltage drops across the devices in that loop. As an example, this is the voltage source. Now, the total voltage across this closed loop must be equal to zero. So A plus B plus C plus D plus E plus F will be equal to zero. It will be more clear when we will solve examples in the following slides. Now, charge carriers lose or gain energy, electrical energy, while passing through a circuit component, for example, cell or resistor. Now, essentially, the energy that we put into the circuit equals the energy that we get out of each circuit loop. Kirchhoff's second law is based upon the law of conservation of energy. Circuit analysis, example one. Now, before I start these examples, generalized form of Kirchhoff's second law to a loop containing any number of components must be equal to sigma vk is equal to 0, where k varies from 1 to n. Now, in this first example, I have drawn this circuit diagram containing three resistors, R1 equal to 3 ohm, R2 equal to 2 ohm, and R3 is equal to 4 ohm. I1 and I2 are current directions that flow towards from IR1 and R2, and I3 is the current flowing through R3, and directions are labeled like this. I1 and I2 are leaving the node and I3 is entering the node. So according to Kirchhoff's first law, sum of I1 and I2 must be equal to I3, and we will prove it in our next slide. Now, taking this circuit diagram as our first example, there are two loops, loop 1 and loop 2. This is the applied potential difference, 12 volts in loop 1 and 5 volts in loop 2. Now, according to Kirchhoff's first law, I1 plus I2 is I3. According to Kirchhoff's second law, sum of EMF must be equal to sum of potential differences across the circuits. Now, in loop 1 in our previous diagram, E1 is equal to V1 plus V3. Once more, just E1, this is E1, is equal to V1 plus V3. Now, obviously, V1 will be equal to I1 R1 and V3 will be equal to I3 R3. Like this. So, name it equation number 1. Now, in loop 2, E2 is equal to V2 plus V3. This is loop 2. V2 plus V3. V2 is I2 R2 plus I3 R3. Label it number 2. We know that EMF has to be supplied by the battery. Now, in left hand loop 1, by substituting the values, we get this equation, label it number 3. In right hand loop, by substituting the values of R and voltages, we get this expression. I have again written the values for resistances and EMF that I have already told in my last slide for the picture, for the circuit diagram. By substituting value of I3 from expression for currents for junction from this expression, we substitute the value of I3 wherever it is here, and we get this expression 5 and 6. Now, these two equations which contain variables I1 and I2, they are two simultaneous equations, and we know that their solution will give the values of I1, I2 and then I3. So, it can be proved that I1 plus I2 is equal to I3. Let's see how. By multiplying equation 5 by 3, we get this expression, and by multiplying equation number 6 by 2, we get this expression. Now, we subtract this equation 8 from equation number 7 and we get value of I1. Now, we substitute the value of I1 in 8 and we will get I2 by these calculations. Therefore, I3, which is equal to I1 plus I2 according to Kirchhoff's first law, will be equal to 1.5 amperes. Example 2. Here I will prove that according to Kirchhoff voltage law, sum of voltages around a closed loop is equal to 0. Now take this simple circuit diagram in which two resistances are in series with each other. According to Kirchhoff voltage law, VAB, voltage drop across AB, plus VBC, voltage drop across point B and C, minus 12 volts is equal to 0, where 12 volts are the voltage supplied by this battery. And why this negative sign? Because current from inside flows from negative to positive terminal. According to Ohm's law, we know V is equal to IR. We substitute the value of VAB and VBC according to Ohm's law, where I into 7 ohm for R1 and 3 ohm for R2. I is same because current in series remains the same. Now, by substituting the values of VAB and VBC from 2 and 3 in equation number 1, we get this expression, and by simplifying, we get current 1.2 ampere. So, we substitute this value of current in equation 2 and 3 and we will get the values of potential drop across AB and BC, which is 8.4 volt for VAB and VBC is 3.6 volts. Now, we put all these values of VAB and VBC in first equation and we get that it is zero. Voltage divider rule. By developing the voltage divider rule, we combine Kirchhoff's laws and current laws. A potential divider is a circuit that produces an output voltage that is a fraction of its input voltage. This is input voltage, this is output voltage across R2. So it is a fraction of the input voltage. Now, the concept behind Kirchhoff voltage law is the law of conservation of voltage and is particularly useful when we deal with series circuits. Series circuits also act as potential dividers and are most commonly used in potentiometers. A potentiometer can act as a variable potential divider in the volume tuning knob attached to our music systems and radio transistors, etc. Other applications include adjusting the signals level for voltage measurement, bias of active devices in amplifiers, and can be used to allow a microcontroller to measure the resistance of a sensor, a multimeter, and Wheatstone bridge, etc. Thank you. See you next time.